Calibration is one of the most important steps in the printing process. If you calibrate well, you'll save yourself a big headache later on. Today, I'm going to show you how to calibrate for perfect prints every time. There are two main parameters that determine the quality of your traces, ink pressure and print height. Ink pressure is the amount of force the piston exerts on the ink during printing. Too much pressure will mean shorts and maybe a pierced cartridge. Not enough pressure means open circuits. Print height refers to the gap between the substrate and the tip of the nozzle. If the nozzle is set too high, the ink might ball on the tip and drop to the substrate in clumps, or more subtly, dispense in a shape that doesn't match the motion of the nozzle, so your traces are too tall and narrow. If the nozzle is too close, it might smear the traces and make them too fat, or just straight up smash the substrate and snap the tip of the nozzle off. The probe measures the Z height of the board, and the print height is relative to that measurement. So if you make a mistake at the probing step, it could mean a broken nozzle or a poor print. A few examples of possible mistakes: the tip of the probe falls into a hole or onto a clamp, or the board deflects because of a poorly clamped substrate. Also, make sure you have the dispenser properly mounted on the carriage. Give it a wiggle and make sure it doesn't move. If the dispenser isn't properly clipped in, it will mess with the print height. All right, let's talk about pressure. The first thing you'll do before mounting the dispenser is prime it. This makes sure the starting pressure is correct. It's a simple process. Just turn this gear counterclockwise until a small amount of ink comes out of the tip. Then turn the gear back a half turn, so from 12 to 6 o'clock. When primed, mount the dispenser and make sure the gears mesh. Time to calibrate. While this test pattern is printing, I'm going to keep a close eye on how the traces are dispensing. These traces are a bit too thin. I'm going to increase the flow a bit. I don't need to stop the calibration process. I can do this while printing by increasing the flow value in the software. You can also tap the right and left arrow keys on your keyboard to increase or decrease the flow. Now you can see that the traces have a good thickness, but there's a little divot in the middle. That's because the nozzle is actually a touch too low and is smushing the trace. I'm going to raise the print height by 10 or 20 micron and see if it looks better. Okay, these traces are looking pretty close to perfect. I think we're about ready to print. Just remember that if you take a few minutes to really nail the calibration step, you'll have a much smoother printing process. Thanks for watching.